Hey, good morning. This is Andy Morrison, K9AWM, on a rainy day in southwest Indiana, where we are getting ready to work mobile on the Indiana QSOParty. Behind me, you can see the mount there that we're going to use, and we're also we'll shoot some video from inside the truck here in just a little while. But just wanted to say good morning, and I'll shoot a little video as we get started with installing the antenna and the radios. Hey, welcome back as we get ready for the Indiana QSOParty on a very rainy day in southwest Indiana. You can see Jerry behind me. Say hi, Jerry.
Hey.
That's KC9ZAR, and we'll turn the camera around, and he's going to explain this antenna. So stand by.
Okay, Jerry, KC9ZAR, tell us about the antenna we're going to use today.
Well, this is a Tar Heel screwdriver, and I picked it up at a ham fest. I did a little work on it, and we've used it a couple times. Works really, really good. And, of course, the mount here in the truck, as you can see, is an old satellite dish mount. The one that you put the concrete blocks on, like on a roof or something to hold it. And I don't have any clamps for this, so I have to use bolts, which makes it a little aggravating. But the antenna works great. We use an FT991A radio, 100 watts, Heil headset, and we have a full-blown mobile operation. Back to you, Andy.
All right, welcome back. We continue the setup for the Indiana QSOParty. And as you can see, Jerry's got the magic box right there.
The magic box.
And we're going to open it up and see what's in it. Stand by.
All right, here we are. The box from last year. So what I have in the box, basically, I keep, of course, the Tar Heel manual, very important for the antenna. I keep the LMR400, the power cable for the radio, the radio manual.
Yes, that's very important.
And I keep a one-to-one balun in here with a stub for the antenna, the control cable for the antenna to move the screwdriver up and down.
Homemade, by the way.
Yeah, homemade. And also from our great friend Raymond down in Warwick County, he gave us a headphone splitter. So we use this headphone splitter and we plug it into the radio, and then Andy has a headset and I have a headset, and we're set to go. So that's about it. We'll get it all hooked up and be back in a minute.
Welcome back as we continue to work the Indiana QSOParty running county lines, and we're mobile right now. Just moving into Martin County, Indiana, and I wanted to take just a moment to kind of point you around our working conditions. So we're going to flip the camera around here. Okay, computer's a little hard to see there, but we're running the N1MM program just on a laptop. Got a Heil headset. Got the Yaesu 991A, the IRLP node that puts us on the APRS map, a little bitty headphone amplifier, so we can each have our own amplified and volume, and then of course a Heil push-to-talk sound bar there. And there's Jerry driving around. He's the navigator today.
Engineer.
Okay, I like that. All right, so that's what we're working with today, and we're going to call some more for Martin County here in just a few minutes.
QRZ for the Indiana QSOParty. Had a November 3 Lima station again, please. There we got you. Thank you very much for calling us. Copy India November Delta Alpha Victor for Davies County, and India November Kilo November Oscar for Knox County. QSL?
QSL 59 Maryland,
right to
Delta.
All right. We've got a pipeline into Maryland tonight. Very good. Thanks for the contact tonight, and good luck in the contest. 7-3. Kilowatt Bravo 3 station again.
India.
All right, got you. Kilowatt Bravo 3, Oscar, Quebec, India. Copy two counties tonight, India November Delta Alpha Victor, and India November Kilo November Oscar. QSL?
All right, we're going to step out and
show you our working conditions. Of course, we are mobile, and we are at the Knox and Davis County line here in Indiana. And we're using a Tar Heel screwdriver. And the back of the pickup truck, as you can see, it's on a satellite dish mount, portable mount. We just have it anchored to the mount, have a one-to-one ballon, and just some coax in the control line running through the back window. And we just happen to be setting exactly the right distance away from this great big reflector that actually gave us a great big pipeline to Maryland and to the East Coast. Don't know if that had anything to do with it or not, but it sure seems like it made a difference when I backed up here and got in the right position. So that's about all from the Knox and Davis County line. This is KC9ZAR, Jerry, and Andy, K9AWM. Okay, guys, here we are live again. We're in Vincennes, Indiana, Knox County. We're still doing the Indiana QSO party. We're having a good time, and what would amateur radio be without ice cream? And Andy is happy. He said he was going to quit calling, so here we are doing ice cream. And I don't know if you can see the truck in the parking lot with the antenna, but there it is. All right, we're got to go. Ice cream's calling. See ya.
Hey, welcome back. We are just about ready to wrap up our activation for the 2019 Indiana QSO party. It has gotten dark since the last time that you've seen us, and everything worked great. We did most of our work on 40 meters. 40 meters was on in pretty good shape, and we ended up with, well, just rough numbers, 289 QSOs and 10,582 points. So not too bad for 100 watts, a Tar Heel antenna in the back of a pickup truck, and driving around. We worked Davies, Knox, Green, Martin, Lawrence, and Orange counties. Did I miss any?
Pike
County, and that was the other one.
Gibson.
And Gibson. My brain is tired, that's why. So anyway, it was a good activation. We did a lot of counting lines and made a lot of QSOs, and so not too bad. Jerry, any final thoughts before we go?
No, this thanks a bunch, Andy, for all your help. It was a blast. I enjoyed it. Thanks for everybody that gave us a call.
All right, that's it. K9AWM and KC9ZAR. We'll see you next year.